An I-team investigation, her family says they have new evidence proving medical experts were wrong. 24-year-old Michelle O'Connell's death 6 years ago was ruled a suicide by multiple agencies. But after having her remains exhumed this past January, her mother says new evidence should get her daughter's case reopened. Patty O'Connell spoke with our own Joy Purdy about the findings. It's an I-team investigation in conjunction with our partners at Crime Watch Daily.
I really think this is the end of the story.
Patty O'Connell calls her excitement a renewed confidence now that she has what she calls new evidence in her daughter's death. 24-year-old Michelle O'Connell's family has fought for years to prove their suspicions. They say she was killed 6 years ago by her then boyfriend, Jeremy Banks, a St. Johns County Sheriff's deputy.
Keep saying, you don't have anything. You don't have anything. You have nothing, you know? Well, I believe with Dr. Anderson, we have a lot. You know, we have proof.
Michelle's remains were exhumed this past January and re-examined by Dr. Bill Anderson, a well-known forensic pathologist based in Orlando who's worked in medical examiner's offices across the country.
We have new evidence, totally new, that's never been brought to light.
Dr. Anderson says Michelle's death was a homicide, despite multiple agencies having already declared her death a suicide. He says blunt force trauma to her mandible, her jawbone, fractured it, incapacitating her before she was shot by someone else.
We are the ones that discovered the fracture only basically at the second autopsy. So all of those people that were making an assumption this was a suicide were unaware of the existence of the fractured mandible. And that's a different injury pattern, and it creates a whole different scenario in the case.
Dr. Anderson and two forensic dentists were asked to look at the O'Connell case by private investigator Clue Wright.
They were kind of hesitant at first to do this, but they agreed to do it, and they agreed to do it for free.
Wright has also donated his services to help the O'Connell family find even more of what he calls ignored evidence, including crime scene photos showing a bloody shirt, a gun holster, along with a black medical glove found on her boyfriend's car. All items Wright says could also help reopen the case.
I think if them pieces of evidence were gathered that night and tested, we wouldn't be sitting here today, and that case would have been solved that night.
It's renewed hope for O'Connell's mother, whose determination, she says, is fueled by her granddaughter, just 4 years old when her mom died.
I hope that we will get justice.
Because we have a chance now to get our point across and get justice for Michelle. If you believe you're right, never give up.